good afternoon. I told you I would be feeling better. Leaving work and heading to class. Oh, I feel so much better. It's not like a Monday thing. You know, like a lot of people when they go to work, they're like, oh, happy Monday, blah, blah, blah. It's not so much that. I don't get those anymore, because if we claim that we're going to have a crappy Monday, then we will. I think it was just more things dealing with internally, so to speak. But I got past it. I'm over it. I got through it, and I'm very happy. I feel good. Let's see, build this light jacket my hair up. Okay. Ooh, I like, you see how that did that swirl? Ooh, maybe I'm glad the seatbelt did that. That's cute. Okay. Anyway, can you see my face? Yeah, I feel good. I was going to stop and see my mom, but we have a weather advisory. It's raining right now, freezing rain. I'm just going to head home. I don't get out of class till after 3. So, I'm going to use some wisdom on today and go to class. Where I go to school is basically 5 minutes from my house, and after that, pick some little din-din up for my baby, pick him up from school, and then just basically head home, and I'll just stop and see her tomorrow. But I just feel so good in my spirit, glad with the decisions that I've been making over the last week. Not a lot of major things, but major enough for me. Obedience to me is the name of the game, and in some areas of my life, God would tell me to do something, I would do it. I always obey, but I just wouldn't obey quickly, which is basically to me the same as not obeying. If you want to get paid on Friday and you're supposed to get paid on Friday and you don't get paid till the following Friday, how would you feel? So that's almost how God views it. If he tells us to do something on Monday, don't wait till Friday. So I've been obeying. That's, I guess, the moral of the story. Let's see what else is new. My nephew, he's moving out with his best friend. He's moving out on his own. He'll be 20 in August. He's like a son, a nephew, but a son. So proud of him. Such a good kid. Oh, can we get this light, please, in Jesus' name? Thank you very much. Okay, yeah, very, very good kid. Has 2 jobs, go to college, just good spirit, saved boy, saved Christian young boy, reads his Bible, knows the word. He's like a little piece of love muffin like my son Jared. And then my other nephew, he was telling me that he's applying for, did he say firefighting or... No, police officer. So, I don't know. I mean, of course, you just pray and keep him safe. It didn't help that I watched this movie over the weekend and had, what is his name? It was a good movie. It was a story about 2 cops that work with the LAPD. And they just happened to be good at their job. Always making crime busts and things like that. But the last bust they made, it was dealing with the drug cartel from Colombia. And they put 2 hits out on these police officers. And it was just sad. Jake Gyllenhaal. That's who's in the movie. And then I forgot the name of the other star. He's Hispanic. I don't remember his name though. But the movie, it's on DVD. It's in red box right now. It was a very good movie. So that's going on with them too. My kids, the other 2, the twins, I don't know what the poo-poos are doing. I really don't. I haven't spoken to them. I pray that they're well. I know that they're well. I see people that they hang around and people that know them as well, kids and adults, and My kids are doing well. My daughter is still displaying interesting behavior. Yeah. And my son somewhat is as well. But they both just need prayer. I wish I could, you know, just really see my daughter. I just want to grab her and hug her, tell her I love her. I feel with her, she doesn't understand the stances that I take. Well, she does, but I have to, I don't know, but I'm always open, you know, for growth. I was just overhearing a conversation someone was having, because they're dealing with a lot of negativity and crazy things that their daughter is, you know, displaying. And, you know, just showing that you still have to stand firm on what you believe, but also still show love and don't judge them. And I had to stop and think, like, am I judging my daughter? She thinks that I have high, my goals are too high for her and her brother, which when she becomes a parent, she'll understand. You know, I want the best for both of them. You know, they may not be able to obtain certain things that I've already obtained, but I would like that to happen. I want them to have a mindset that, you know, being cool just isn't getting a new pair of True Religion pants. What's cool is obtaining another degree, you know, things like that. But I know they have a ways to get there. But my daughter, the streets are just, they're just kind of her best friend right now. And I wish that the streets would leave her alone. I do. And my daughter would choose to break up with the streets. But it's just so many little things. I mean, I miss her. She's my, kind of my mini-me. You know, a lot of people say like, oh, you look just like your daughter, or your daughter, you know, my daughter looks like me. And I always have a rebuttal and say, well, when she starts acting like me, then give me a memo. Until then, okay, it's neither here nor there. Like, I'll even tell my son, I see so many people, they want to give him so many accolades, how awesome he is. Oh, well, Lord, keep that lady safe in Jesus' name. Sorry about that. I don't care how amazing my son is on the field. How is his character when he gets off the field? Is he respectful? Does he have a good name? You know, things like that. And, you know, the people that are coming to me being all hype about my son, they even stop and look at me like, well, you're right. But I don't think my son gets it. You know, the older he gets, and I think it's always like that, especially with sons too. You can be telling your children something, explaining to them, you know, why they shouldn't do certain things. Some things deserves an explanation, then some things you just listen to your parent. That's all. Trust them enough. But someone else can come in and say the exact same thing, and like a light bulb comes on. It's almost like ministry. You know, you can be in a ministry, your pastor can be sharing the same thing. The pastor's wife could have said the same thing a million times, and they invite a guest speaker to come in, and then now some of the members get it. They're like, oh, is that what the man of God was trying to say? Well, you've been trying to say that for the last year. You just haven't been open to receive it. But that's what happens sometimes when we get too comfortable with the people that are around us. It doesn't matter how long you've known someone, you should still respect them enough to hear what they have to say. If you trust that they wouldn't do anything to harm you, why not take their advice? Just thinking about my babies. I mean, if you're a parent and you're dealing with kids that are, you know, out there, it's enough to make 5 videos every day. It is. But all is well. You know, God bless me with one that I'm still raising, and I have a capacity to instill values into him. And even my twins, is not too late. You know, I don't believe that. Some days I kind of feel like that, like last week when I think I made a video about my daughter. And some of the comments that I found out she said about me on Facebook, as far as like, you know, loving somebody and hating them at the same time, especially when they birthed you, blah, blah, blah. But, you know, to me, I've learned to separate, you know, the mommy versus the minister. And the minister was basically showing me, I miss my mother. Why do things have to be the way that they are? Does this car know what it wants to do? Jesus, because she's on the phone. I'm on the phone too, but I have control right now. At least as I'm driving, I'm not directly looking into the phone until I come to a stoplight. But anyway, praise ye the Lord. What was I saying? You just about my kids. I think I'll probably make a video about my kids every week because it helps me mentally. It has been helping me. Just learn how to forgive, and when a lot of people have your kids' attention, it's like a constant fight all the time. Constant fight. And I'm not giving up on them at all in any way, shape, or form. However, for me and my house, we shall serve the Lord. You know, I love them. If they ever call me and need me. Now, my daughter probably disagreed because she called me or texted me a few times and asked me to come help her, you know, do a couple things. She wanted money and things like that. And I didn't come aid her. But just a few days before, I'm saying like Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, I was all type of names and being disrespected. So by Thursday, she needed assistance. And she doesn't understand, it doesn't work like that. At least with me, it doesn't. You can't disrespect me Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and then need me to bail you out of some of everything by Thursday and expect for me to be there and join you on the spot. Now, if you call me Thursday, mommy, I'm sorry, I messed up again. I shouldn't have said that to you. I shouldn't have spoken to you in that manner. I apologize. Even though she's probably just saying it just to get the help that she needs from me, but it's better than nothing. At least she had enough sense and wisdom to respect me as her mother. But, nah, she's not there yet. So, I didn't help her. You know, it goes back to, you know, call me when you don't need anything. That's relationship. You want a relationship with me? Okay, let's spend time without me spending any money. Let's spend time without me giving you any money. Because when you don't want to be bothered with me, you seem to manage then. I feel air in this car. Like, it's, I don't know if the, what is it called? If the sunroof is open. Which way? Which side is the thing on? I forgot. I hope it's on my side. Okay, thanks for watching. Be blessed. I have to go. Bye-bye.